Good morning, students. Have you ever thought of a situation when there is a student who is considered, who himself considers as innocent, not very clever, and ugly in appearance? The behavior of other children and even the family members of himself or herself is changed, isn't it? It is a real fact. The one who is not good looking means ugly looking, especially, and very innocent by heart, is not very clever. He becomes the target of his fellows. Even the family members also do not give any importance to such people in the family members. It is a fact. It is a real life situation. So, Boli of this story is the central character of our story, and she is such a person who is ugly looking. Though her name is Sulekha, but she is called Boli. Even in your class, you keep and you give different names to your fellow beings, but it is not good children. This Boli, actually, we cannot say she is, actually, she is very ugly looking. She is very innocent by heart, and therefore she was made target by her family members even. Then, now we come to the writer. The writer of this story is K.A. Abbas, Mr. K.A. Abbas, who is a playwright, who is a journalist, who is a story writer, and he even made films. Inki films hai Do Bund Pani aur Saath Hindustani, and he has a command over Urdu, English, and Hindi. All the three languages he has command over them. He is a novelist, he is a short story writer, filmmaker, film director. So he has shown his skill in this story very precisely. It touches our heart. Actually, the major theme of that story, Boli, is the impact of family on children. What kind of behavior is done with, or what kind of behavior is done by the family members with the children. And that has a long-lasting effect throughout his or her life and career. If someone gets a fantastic environment, we can say parents support them. Parents support is needed. Such children grow up in their lives. The basic requirement of the development of the personality is the family environment, parents. As we have already studied about Dr. APJ Kalam, isn't it? Though his parents were not much qualified, but they had a wisdom. Though they did not have, though were not very wealthy, but they had enough resources to provide their children, but the qualities, the values that they imbibed in him, it made him the greatest man, I must say, greatest man of the world. Here, it is the opposite case. So it is the life of Boli. Actual name was Sulekha. The life of Bholi, the little girl who falls to develop, who fails to develop the self-confidence, and because of why did she lose her confidence? Because of her parents' attitude towards her. When parents did not like their children, they did not behave properly with their children, how could a child develop? So this story hints at why the family support is important, and it acts as an emotional security, isn't it? It acts as emotional security, which is the most important fact or factor which is required for the development of a child. So even disabled children must be given. It is not that only family members, even disabled children should also be given the encouragement. The arrangement should be made for them, love and education like other people. They should not be deprived of any education. They should be provided with the facilities, whatever they want, whatever is needed for them. Okay, so you must have understood that Sulekha, or according to our family members, Bholi is the central character of the story. Naturally, when a child is innocent, not very clever, not very intelligent, even the more important thing that he or she is not good looking, means she was ugly looking, it was a factor that brought worry to her parents. So we come to the chapter. Her name was Sulekha, and since her childhood, everyone called her Bholi. Got it? She was the fourth daughter of Nambardar Ramlal. Her father's name was Ramlal, and he was a Nambardar. Nambardar is a post in British Empire whose assignment was, whose job was to collect taxes in the area. Got it? So her father was a Nambardar, and when she was 10 months only, she fell off from the cot. Cot means charpai. So she fell off from the cot, and there was injury in her head, and perhaps that has damaged some part of her brain, and after that she remained a backward child. Her development was not properly reached. She could not be developed as the other children were doing, and therefore she was named Bholi. At birth, the child, means Bholi, was fair and pretty, but when she was 2 years old only, she had the attack of smallpox. एक तो पहले ही वो कॉर्ड से गिर गई, सिर में चोट लगी. अपार्ट फ्रॉम इट, देयर वाज एन अटैक ऑफ स्मॉल पॉक्स. देन व्हेन शी वाज, अपार्ट फ्रॉम इट, शी हैड रिमेन्स ऑफ दोज मार्क्स, चिकन पॉक्स ऑन हर फेस एंड आईज एज वेल. दिस सुलेखा actually was permanently disfigured by deep pock marks, and she could not speak till she was 5 years old. Means one or the other factor added to the negative aspect of her life. First of all, she fell off from the cot, then the attack of smallpox that made various or that had given various pock marks on her face. Then she could not speak till she was 5. And the other members of the neighborhood, they made fun of her, made satire on her, mimicked her even. You must be knowing the meaning of mimicry. When she started speaking, she stammered. Okay? She stammered. Haklati thi wo. So as a result, she started speaking less. When the others were making fun of her, she started speaking less. See the condition or the environment of the family. Then Ramlal had 7 children, and there were 3 sons and 4 daughters. She was the youngest of all and named Bholi. It was a prosperous farmer's household. Actually, Nambardar was a post in the British Empire, as I told you, British rule. So it was a good and prosperous family. Then all the children except Bholi were healthy and were developing well. They were sent to get the education. They got married. All the children were gradually and slowly settling down in their families. So it was not difficult for healthy and good-looking girls to find the bridegrooms for them. But what about Bholi? Ramlal was worried about Bholi. He was much worried about her. When Bholi was only 7 years old, her elder sister Mangla was married. The same year, a primary school opened in her village. The Tehsildar Sahib came to perform its opening ceremony. Tehsildar and Nambardar worked under him. Okay? So Tehsildar came over there for the opening ceremony of the school. Then he said to Ramla that as he was the revenue official of the village and the representative of the government in the village, so he must set an example to the villager and he must send his daughters to school. Then Ramlal consulted his wife that what to be done. She cried that if he was mad, she cried at her husband that he was being crazy. If what did she say? If girls go to school, what? Who will marry such a girl? And you won't believe that it was a fact. You ask your grandmothers that they must have faced some difficulty in fighting for an education. It is not your mother's time, your grandmother's time. They must have faced such a situation. If they were interested in getting education, they must have been stopped, they must have been denied or got married early. That was the culture and system at that time. It was a matter of only 40 to 50 years back. So he shouted at his wife, but Ramlal had no courage to disobey the orders of Tehsildar. He instructed him to set an example before the villagers. So at last, his wife said, okay, that he would tell him what to be done. Send Bholi to school. She suggested to send Bholi to school, and it was They knew that there was a little chance of her marriage, so at least she would get some education in the school. Okay, and see the attitude of her mother. What did she say? Let her teachers at school worry about her. Just imagine. उसने कहा कि चलो अब वहां के स्कूल के टीचर्स पर इसकी चिंता छोड़ देते हैं. ओके, सच वाज द सिचुएशन एंड एटमॉस्फेयर इन हर फैमिली. देन नेक्स्ट डे रामलाल टुक भोली टू स्कूल एंड भोली इवन वाज फ्राइटेंड एट दैट टाइम. शी डिड नॉट स्पीक टू एनीवन. शी डिड नॉट go out of the house regularly, and she was frightened when her father asked her to go to school. He took her by her hand, okay, and she did not know even what a school was. Just think, Holi did not know what a school was, and she remembered how a few days ago their old Now Lakshmi, old cow Lakshmi, had been turned out of the house and sold. Now she remembered the situation when the old cow Lakshmi was thrown out of the house and sold. She remembered that situation. Okay. Then she said, "No, no, no, no." She stammered a lot. Even she did not have courage to give her consent or refusal. उसको इतनी भी हिम्मत नहीं थी कि वो अपने फादर को हाँ या ना कह पाती. What did she say? "No, no, 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 no." And she shouted with terror. She was so terrified and pulled her hand away from her father's grip. अपना फादर का हाथ छुड़ाकर ही भाग गई वो. Then shouted Ramlal that, "Are you fool? What are you doing?" That if she had gone fool, mad. Then he told her that he was taking her to the school only. And he told his wife that let her wear some decent dress, decent clothes, so that what would teachers think of him? Just think the psychology of Ramlal. He was asking his wife to arrange for good clothes for Bholi for the sake of others, that what others would think, what the teachers in the school would think of him. Then the teachers and other school girls would think of him. वो उसके दिमाग में क्या था आइडिया, क्या साइकोलॉजी थी कि उसके टीचर्स और दूसरे स्कूल गर्ल्स बोली के बारे में और स्पेशली रामलाल के बारे में क्या सोचेंगे. ओके, देन न्यू क्लॉथ्स हैड नेवर बीन मेड फॉर बोली. शी हैडन्ट गॉट एनी न्यू ड्रेस टू वियर. She was always provided with the leftover dresses of her sisters. Then no one cared even to wash or mend those clothes even. No one cared. And she was even bathed and oil was rubbed into her dry and matted hair. उसको तैयार किया गया, नहलाया गया. It was not a regular customary system, but that day she was given a bath, her hair were combed, then she was given. Then only she thought that she was being taken to a safe place, and she started believing that she was being taken to a place better than her home, better than her house. Such a fear was created in Bolly's mind. Just to think how the horrible scene must be there at Bolly's house, how much she was afraid of her father, isn't it? When it was again a matter of status that she should be given a proper dress to wear, she should be given a bath, and hair should be combed. Just because what the others, means the teachers in the school and the fellow students in the school, would think of him, and therefore she was given good dress to wear. She was properly dressed and got ready. Then she started thinking that she might be taken to a place better than her home. Just see what was the condition of Bolly. When they reached to the school, the children were already in their classrooms. Children reached to the classrooms, and Ramlal, when reached to the school, when he reached there, he handed over Bolly to the headmistress and left alone. The poor girl looked about her with fear-laden eyes. She was looking at the headmistress with fear-laden eyes. Just imagine how much fear she had in her heart. She was looking at the teacher, means headmistress, with fear. Her eyes had fear. Then there were several rooms, and each room, girls like her, they were squatted there on mats. They were sitting on mats, okay? It was a scene of the school at that time, okay? She saw that the girls were sitting on mats. They were reading books and writing on slates. Do you know them? Have you ever heard about slates? Slates were a wooden board painted black where children used to write with chalk like those pencils, like chalks. Even in my childhood, I also had those slates, and we even carried the ink bottle and ink pen every day to the school with us. So it was the story of the period when the children used to write on a slate. Okay, so it was a scene in the classroom. Bolly was taken to class, and she was asked to enter and sit in the class. So Bolly found a corner seat in the class. Okay. Now Bolly did not know what a school exactly like. She did not know what was a school. उसको यही नहीं पता था कि स्कूल क्या होता है, एंड व्हाट हैपेंड देयर, होता क्या है और वहां किस लिए जाते हैं. शी डिड नॉट नो एनीथिंग अबाउट द स्कूल. शी इवन हैडंट हर्ड द नेम ऑफ स्कूल, एंड शी वाज ड्रॉप्ड बाय हर फादर देयर. ओके, सो शी वाज glad to find so many girls almost of her own age present there. She hoped that these girls, or any one of these girls, might become her friend. She started hoping that. She was thinking that one or the other might become her friend. So we will continue